Oh, there is another guard, but why aren't they attacking me?
Oh.
Guess I spoke too soon.
The Wasteland has claimed your life. Arroyo attempts to send out others to search for the Gek.
They do, huh? Let me see if I can do this. In the past, it's always crashed, but I have a new version of Bandicam running. Excellent. Okay. Alright, so don't go past into this. Got it. Figured they could have a sign saying keep out or something, but nope. No help. So I'm thinking go over here. Oh wait, how do I get in there? I get in this way. Can I try one of these passwords? Or will they immediately attack again? Chemistry workstation. Okay, the low she password. Chemistry database. Fuel and derivatives. Polymers. You come across a vast array of complex chemical formula and lab notes. You're not quite sure what all this means. Direct fuel along pipeline. Destination required. Okay, polymers. Once you have waded past the symbology and technical discussion, you discover that the Shi are working on a new kind of polymeric combat armor that is resistant to both flame and penetration. It is still years from completion. You also see mention of new weaponry and construction capabilities. Apparently the Shi have some plans for the future. After sifting through some of the complex chemical formula and lab notes, you come to the conclusion that the Shi have created a kind of fuel from plant extracts and sea life. Apparently, they have hooked into previously existing pipelines so they can transport fuel to a wide variety of destinations. Destination required. So we don't have a destination then. Alright, I don't see the reason to deactivate the workstation. I'll log out. I guess once we've done what we need to do, deactivate it so no one can undo it, that kind of thing. So the low she password, that is the chemistry password. Okay, so we also have, sorry guys, physics and biology. So now it tells us which the workstations are, actually. And people don't care, they're just standing here. This is the physics station. Ken Lee. Physics database. Exploration theory. Exploration. We are still preparing a working model of an aerial vehicle. None of the designs we've created have proven to be safe or aerodynamic. Perhaps if we had access to the plans of the ancients. Dr. Wong. Theory. After wading through the introduction and the mathematics, you discover that the Shi are learning to develop nuclear power again, rebuilding the space travel theories of the ancients, and they mock the herbologists while doing so, and harnessing the energy of the sun, wind, and sea. At least that's what the notes read like. Alright, so what am I going to do with that information? Stop whining, Myron. If I had some cheese to go with that wine, I'd have a severe lactose problem because, yeah, I have a lactose problem. And that'd be a lot of freaking cheese, because God. We've reinvented whining, I think. So then this must be biology. Activate station. Donkey punch. Data to find. Botany program, genetic program, xeno program. Xeno? Like as in aliens? Let's go in order. Botany program. After about 20 minutes, you discover this. Initial results of botanical radiation disruption prove unpromising. Dr. Sheng develops radiation-resistant plant life. Unpleasant side effects follow. Resultant plant life deemed too dangerous. Sheng insists on pursuing line and mixing it with genetic program. Genetic program. After about 20 minutes, you piece together this information. Using the basics of the FEV virus, remember that one? Dr. Long Wang is convinced of success in creating mutant soldiers. He creates a serum providing interesting results with rodent experiments. He injects himself and dissolves into a puddle of goo. Dr. Sheng disables line of inquiry. With the death of Dr. Long, Dr. Sheng is in charge. Sheng demands focus on radiation-consuming plant life. See if it says anything different here or no. Okay, Xeno program. The subject on which we had hoped to establish a series of meaningful experiments has disappeared, presumed either destroyed or stolen by the herbologists. Further inquiries have proven fruitless. Until such time as further specimens are obtained, the database remains inoperative. Dr. Sheng. So they got an alien here? We got like a Roswell thing going on? Recent personnel notes. Dr. Wong, new head of biology project in addition to physics research. Dr. Sheng, biology project head until 2 months ago. 1 month sabbatical with new botany sentience serum accounted for. Further absence of puzzle. Dr. Wong assumes control of biology program. Dr. Long recently deceased via FEV serum. Biology project head until 2 months ago. Sure what to do with this information, but you are in my way, good sir. What's the rush? The broodlings need entertainment. That's the rush. This guy, everything new to say. So what's the deal with this Dr. Sheng? How do you know about Dr. Sheng? I suppose it doesn't matter. Dr. Sheng Ming was a brilliant but rather unpleasant man who served as my predecessor. He is no longer of any great relevance here. So what happened to him? What happened? I'd say he lost his mind. During his experiments, he stumbled upon something which I admit was rather remarkable, but it was also extremely dangerous and in no way related to the goals of the Xi. But that did not matter to Dr. Sheng. He became obsessed with his creation, and since his experiments were deemed too dangerous to continue here, he decided to take them elsewhere. He left on sabbatical and never returned. That is when I stepped up to fill his position. What kind of experiments was Dr. Sheng performing, and what exactly was his big discovery? As a man of science, I respect your inquisitive nature. However, I am afraid I'm not willing to share the secrets of the Xi with you, stranger. I like that. So where is Dr. Sheng now? Dr. Sheng was escorted a day or so to the south. He took up residence in some abandoned home. If I'm not mistaken, he was only supposed to be gone for a month. Or some abandoned home, if I'm not mistaken. He was only supposed to be gone for a month, but it's been much longer, and we have yet to hear from him. If I were to guess, I'd say he was either destroyed by his own creations, or else fell victim to the numerous hazards of the wasteland. I think I'd like to follow up on this Dr. Sheng guy. Can you give me his last known location? I suppose I could. Must admit, I am somewhat curious to learn of his fate. Here, I'll mark Dr. Sheng's last known location on your mapping device, but I must warn you that it could prove to be highly dangerous. Of course, it is always dangerous out there in the wastes. Anyway, if you find anything of interest, do let me know. That's Dr. Wong. Now that we know what we know, I wonder if we can get any more info. Yeah, that sounds great. I would love that power armor, but it's years from completion. I don't have years, baby. I just don't. Let me check this again. For anything else now that we have. So Dr. Wong is a new head of biology. Dr. Long is dead. Just check with these guys first, and I'll check in that temple or whatever the hell it is again. Oh, do these guys, do any of them say anything? One of these days will be done. No, they don't have anything to say, really. Unless this guy, no, I doubt him either. Oh god. Vic, come on. You best to be sorry. Alright. I like that though. Fallout, danger. Awesome. I will just talk to this guy again now that we've found out some information. Maybe I have something else to say. Ken Lee. Oh no, so we don't have the option to ask him for fuel anymore. Alright. Oh, are we done in here? That's kind of a long episode for just nothing. Okay, so I don't know what vault that is. Lo Wei. You'll not speak with Lo Wang. Alright, let's... You know what? The guy that... This other guy... In the ship sold his... spleen to, I believe? Is this the place? He mentioned a store. Where's the door? Yeah, Lo Wei. It might be him. Flying Dragon 8. I am looking for a spleen. Where can I find vertebrate plans? Look to the north in Navarro. There's a hidden base near the gas station. I'm looking for a spleen. A spleen? Haha! Yes, Chip from the Valdez lost his spleen in a card game the other day. I sold it to Dr. Wong. He was fascinated by it. Oh my, okay, we just came from there. How do you lose a spleen? He was very drunk. Very, very drunk. He was obsessed with his spleen all night long, and then he bet on it. So you took his spleen? Yes, it was a debt. He's an honorable man. Well, I didn't get to ask where Dr. Wong is, but I know where he is. I understand I need an FOB fob to access the Valdez's computer. Oh, same. I need some computer parts for the PMV Valdez. Have you tried looking in the old vaults? I hear that they have a wealth of information and technology of the ancients. Yes, I have. I hear some flying machines brought a load of villagers down this way. They did not. They came from the north and flew over us, heading out over the sea. I'm leaning like a can of sardines. Oh, over the horizon? How the hell do I get there? Well, none of our boats are capable of that kind of distance. Unless you can get the old tanker on the docks working. It's an old ship, but probably still functional, if some work is put into it. Ask the punks for more information. What else can you tell me about the tanker? Even if you could get the navcom working and the tanker fueled up, you'll still need considerable good fortune if you really want the ship to sail again. What do you mean by considerable good fortune? I mean the hunk of junk is older than most ghouls. It would be a miracle if it didn't sink on you. That's all I meant. I have a feeling that there's something you're not telling me about the tanker. Even the way I read it was kind of... was fishy, huh? No pun intended. Perhaps there is, smiles. Perhaps the wasteland has made you paranoid. Come on, what's so special about the tanker? We're just two people talking. Let's talk then. But there's nothing special about the tanker. I give you my word. What if I paid you to tell me? Business has been slow lately. I could use some more customers, or a donation from a very generous one. Say, 2,000? Fine. I don't want to give him 1,500 for nothing. Here you go, but your information better be worth it. Lo Chow pockets the $2,000. It's not the tanker that's special. It's just a big rusty tanker, like you said. Our submarine, on the other hand... Submarine? The Shi Huang Ti. My great-grandfather, Ye Li, was his captain. He unleashed her nuclear fires like a horrible dragon upon California's coast. No shit. Ironically, a malfunctioning missile from our own ancestral nation went off course and exploded over the ocean near the submarine's location. The blast knocked out the Shi Huang Ti's systems, leaving Captain Ye Li and his crew stranded at sea. Well, that's karma for you. But there was salvation. After weeks of drifting, the sub finally came to rest out in the shallow waters of the San Francisco Bay. This city became our new home. We eventually restored the Shi Huang Ti, its targeting systems, its weapons. It has enough firepower to blow any potential invaders out of the water. So even if you got that old tanker running, it wouldn't get far, as a submarine will destroy any non-Chinese vessel that sails through the bay. That sounds like a problem, right? So how would I get to the submarine? You swim. Or take the motorboat at the docks. It is guarded, though, by one of the best soldiers, and he will not let an outsider like you past him. You have any idea how I can get past him, then, without shooting him in the face? He's under strict orders to guard it 24/7. He will not let anyone out without the right password through. I don't suppose you know it. That depends. I don't suppose you have $10,000 to ensure the continued prosperity of my shop? Not yet, anyway. That's almost all the rest of my money. No deal. You're lost, then. I don't believe we have anything else to discuss. Goodbye. Bye. Damn it. I can't schmooze him. I got speech and stuff. I wonder if he has money and stuff. Trying to see if he's replenished his money here. Well, he has stuff I can buy, certainly. Wow. Scout, yeah, he's got all these books. I'm sure we have a few more guns that we can sell. Let's see if it has anything. He's got junk. We can't sell junk. Flamethrower fuel, pretty much, yeah. That's right, we can fulfill that quest. For the beer, the different kinds of beer over at Vault City. Okay. If I can, I'll take the minigun. Actually, I'll take the H&K. Because probably can't carry the minigun at this point. Nice. Alright. Apparently this guy has no money, but he does have a bunch of books. Chemistry journals, I guess, for science. Guns and bullets, I can't benefit from that any longer. Too high in skill. First aid's really high as well. Yeah. Dean's Electronics. Book of Science. The chemistry journals are new. I don't remember seeing those. So I can carry this crap. And then... I'll just give him money for the stuff left over. Too bad he doesn't sell syringes, that's all I gotta say. Oh, a field medic first aid kit, that's nice. Yeah, first aid and small guns are pretty full. Alright. Okay, so almost 200. I mean, 2,000. Yeah, shows you how good I am at math. Actually, please, 200, I mean, 2,000. 750. So I'm guessing 1800. This is just an educated guess. 1806. Well, that was really close. I cannot carry that much. Wow. Hope this works. I don't want to have to keep... You know what? Take all these. One tool. I think we're good. All right. All right, so 574. I don't want to do that. Damn it. It's the books. It's all those damn books. Man, I don't want to keep messing around like this. One book? 47.97. Alright, so $47. I hope. Thing is, without that, I don't have the full benefit of these books. It doesn't tell me the weight, unfortunately. Okay, gonna be losing out on this deal. How much do these books weigh? Good God. Yeah, I bet that's a good trade for you. Alright, now read these books. Dean's Electronics. So this is for repair. Repair is at 64. Wrong thing. I say it was at 64? 70%. Nice. Alright, and then science is 61. I only got one of these, unfortunately. Science 64. Getting smart about science. Now how... Yeah, I don't...
What you be needing?
How much weight do you have on you? A lot. Never mind then. Oh, Vic. Vic to carry some stuff. Hopefully you can carry more. Yeah. See how much this stuff weighs. Doesn't he have a rope? Yeah. Let him hold the microfusion cells, actually. We got an extra tool. I was gonna sell one, that's right. That is a lot of 223s. Should have actually see if he can give me another gun. No, I think he didn't have anything else. He also has a rope. What you be needing?
What you be needing?
He can't use the power fist, that's so disappointing. Combat shotgun. Oh, I have a few of those. Alright. Let's see if I can sell for some stuff now. Science books, these are actually chemistry journals. Can I use those as books? Yeah, I was figuring they could, but they are different, aren't they? What if I just get one of them for now, see what the effect is? This crap. You know what? We tend to use up ropes. So let me hold on to my rope. Extra tool, though. We'll do that. Alright. $87. So weird calling them dollars. No. Where was I wrong? Man. So 26? At least that time I'm right. Okay. Let's see about these chemistry journals.